Hi guys, this is Jordan with Motion Array. When you edit a video, one of the most important things that you want to try and create is flow. Now, when we use the word flow, we mean a continuous movement throughout your video. It's really hard to quantify this term because it's something that a good video just makes you feel. But really, the end goal of flow is to make sure that your audience feels like your visuals, your story, and even your audio are being carried throughout your video in a natural way. Think of a stream. The flow of water is not only progressional, meaning continuously moving, but it's also directional. It's not going any which way, but it's going exactly where the stream boundaries take it. There's a specific start and end to the stream movement, and an entire journey in the middle. This is one of the reasons that transitions are so popular for creating enjoyable videos. They help to naturally take you to the next point of your video without feeling a bump or a stutter to interrupt you, which is what a harsh cut can sometimes make you feel. Interrupted. This is already a long intro. Why are we talking about this? Well, it's because I'm gonna show you guys one easy way to create better flow in your videos. So get on your computer and open up Premiere, because we're gonna take a look at how to create better flow using speed ramping. So now we're in Premiere Pro, and we have a few clips here put in succession. Right now they're just regular speed with no transitions, and they just cut from one to the next. Also, just a quick heads up, the footage I'm using in this example was shot in slow motion. Normally, we might add a transition, but I don't want to draw attention to the transition by adding something flashy. We just want to make the change from one clip to another feel more natural, more intentional, and more invisible. So how do we do that using speed ramping? First, let's open up our speed ramping capabilities for our clip box. Right-click your clip and then go down to Show Clip Keyframe, Time Remapping, and Speed. From here, you'll see that there's this little line that doesn't stand for opacity anymore, but instead it's representing the speed the clip is being played back at, which right now is 100%. Our goal for this clip is to speed it up close to the end where the cut happens between the two clips, like we're accelerating into the cut. But if we make an adjustment to our speed here, it makes a change for the entire clip and not just for the section that we want. What we're going to do is simply take the end of our clip here and make a keyframe by holding Control or Command and clicking. Now we can control this side independent from this side. Let's raise this end up to make it faster. You'll notice the clip will move around when you make a change to the speed. Keep in mind that the duration of your clips will either lengthen or shorten when you make these changes. But the actual point within the clip that it starts and stops will remain the same. Let me show you what I mean. In this example, our clip ends when our subject here turns her head a bit. Even if we change the speed really drastically, it will change the duration, but it will still end with her head turning. Let's go back to our other example. There's still a problem. Our video clip jumps into fast motion, and it's kind of jarring and doesn't look that great. So we can ramp up the speed by dragging out this keyframe here. The farther you drag it, the more gradual the change will be. Finally, if you want the change to be less linear and more explosive, you can take this marker here and rotate it to make an S-curve. Here's what that looks like in comparison. It's subtle, but it can change a bit of the tone that you want to set for your video. That's looking better. Now remember that the goal for this effect is that we want to have the cut happen at the height of the acceleration. But this is only half the story. What we want to do next is the opposite with the next clip. We want it to start fast and then ramp down to normal speed. Take this exact same setup that we did for our previous clip and apply it to the beginning of the next one in reverse. And now the effect should look like this. Now guys, that's technically the entirety of the effect, but it's really only half the battle. Like we've mentioned before on other videos, audio is key to your project, so adding a couple sound effects can take this effect miles further. Here's two suggestions that I would give. Place a very subtle sound effect down as an indicator to your audience for the speed change. Something like a whoosh or even a riser could help sell this effect more. If you want to make your own custom riser, check out this previous video we did, and the link is in the description below. So we're going to add a whoosh sound effect here that sounds like this. But once we add it in, we notice that it's a little bit too loud. So we're going to bring it down in volume so that it's really soft. And now this is what it sounds like. It's kind of there, but it's really too intense even when we drop the volume down. So we're actually now going to drop the speed of this effect way down, to around 35%. Slowing this down will make it sound more gradual and help it blend in with everything else that's going on. Your results might vary depending on what sound effect you're using. I'm using a whoosh sound effect from Motion Array's library, and the link to the sound effects pack is in the description below if you want to check it out for yourself. We're not trying to draw attention to the effect, we're just trying to make it feel like it's actually happening by giving subtle audio cues. And now when we add it at the point of transition, this is what it sounds like. It's so subtle, but it works so well. Lastly, what we can do to really help blend these two clips together is to have sounds that remain unchanged between the two clips. Ambient noises are great for this. Both of these clips, for example, are set in a forest. So let's take the ambient sound of a forest. We'll make it sound soft as if it's in the background, and then we'll take it and stretch it out over both sides of the cut. This way, our audio cues are telling our audience that there's a connection between these two clips, like they're happening in the same area. Lastly, I'm just going to drop in some subtle music to give some extra character to our video, and I'm also going to go ahead and do exactly what we've been working on for this video for all of the clips on our timeline. So now with all of that combined, let's take a look at our final video. And guys, that's it. That's how you add a speed ramp to your video and stylize it to get the most impact possible. I hope you found this video helpful, and I hope you can see how sometimes the most simple and subtle changes can result in the biggest impacts for your video. Just so you know, all of the sound effects and music we used were right here from motionarray.com. We've also got way more tutorials for Premiere Pro, After Effects, and filmmaking in general. Feel free to check it all out. But that's it for me. I hope to see you in the next video.